So we'll be talking today about the elastic analysis of the bolted joint, and that is bolt having initial tightening load. And when we talk of the elastic analysis, that means the bolt is stretched in a joint within the Hooke's law, within the elastic limit, and we will see the effect of initial tightening on the total load carrying capacity of the load. That means we will also find out the share of the or the part of the total external load shared by the bolt in the bolted joint and the part of the load that will be shared by the component in the joint. And we will also talk about the fluctuating load on the bolts. You will find out the diameter of the bolt required in a joint which is subjected to fluctuating load using Godman's equation, and we'll also see what should be the maximum load on the bolt to make it leak proof, and some more problems on the bolts. So this will be the end of the bolted joint after discussing these topics. Welcome. We will continue discussion on elastic analysis of the bolted joint. When you talk of elastic analysis, that means the bolt is elastically stretched upon the loading, and the stress strain diagram is within the limit, that is within the linear limit or within the Hooke's law, that's obey the Hooke's law within the elastic limit. So the bolt which is being loaded, maybe tensile and compressive, whatever, maybe it is within the elastic limit. So when the bolt is loaded by tightening the knots, the the bolt become a tensile member, as like a tensile member. That means stress or tensile stress is induced in the bolt, or tension is induced in the bolt. And we consider the stress strain relationship within the Hooke's law, and let us consider this member. This is plate 1 or plate 2 or member 1 or member 2. They are joined with the help of a bolt, and this is the knot, and this side is the bolt, and when you tighten this, it will exert on pressure, exert on compressive load on these two plates, and the same amount of load will be shared by the bolt, and which will be in tensile nature. So if you consider the load displacement relationship, so the P is equal to K into delta, and delta is equal to PL by A. This is the formula. P is the load, L is the length of the bolt, A is the area of the cross section of the bolt, E is the elastic limit, and delta is the deflection or the deformation that has happened in the bolt. And if you rearrange them, it will be P is equal to AE by L into delta. So this is in the form of P is equal to K delta, or the equation of the spring. The force is equal to spring constant into deflection. So AE by L, area into elastic limb, Young's modulus, elastic modulus divided by length, is the stiffness of the plate. So whether it is a bolt or these members, we can consider them as a spring. This plate 1, plate 2, when they are kept side by side, this will be assuming spring. This is spring 1 and spring 2 having stiffness K1 and K2, and this will be area 1 into material AE by L. This is A2, E2 by L2, like that. So if you see this bolt as an elastic member and having some stiffness, the stiffness of the bolt will be area of the bolt into the Young's modulus of the bolt divided by length of the bolt. So this will be the stiffness of the bolt, and the load will be the stiffness of the bolt KB into the deformation that has happened in the bolt. So P is equal to A by bolt. And if in this case, this instead of area pi by 4 d square, it is the diameter of the bolt, L is the length or the total thickness of the part to be held by the bolt. In this case, this from here to here, the total thickness of the part is that to be held by the bolt together is known as. If there are two components here, so they will be acting as two springs in series. And you can find out for series the effective stiffness of the spring, K effective is equal to 1 by K1 plus 1 by K. If K1 and K2 are the stiffnesses of individual members, so the K effective is equal to K1, K2 divided by K1 plus K2. Now, when you compress a member, it actually, if you press this bolt, if tighten place these two members with the help of the bolt, if you press these two, if two members with the help of the bolt, the portion which is from here to here, about if this is the diameter of the bolt D, about 1.5 D from in this location and 1.5 D from this side, this area of the this plate's cross section is under the compression. So that's why I am representing here. So this is the hole through which the bolt will pass, and from here it 1.5 D, and from here 1.3 D, and this will be the area, this will be the total area is actually under the compression. So that's why if you want to find out the stiffness of the plate, if you want to, when you tighten the bolt, so the 3D amount of the area is under compression. So if you want to find out the stiffness of plate 1 and plate 2, and in this case we consider plate 1 and 4 to having some made up of same material. So the area into E by L in this case will be pi by 4, 3D square minus D square, that is equal to, this is equal to 2 pi D square. In the square, because this is 9 d square minus d square, so in this case it will be 8 d square divided by 4, so it will be 2 pi d square. So it is 3 d square, that will be 9 d square minus d square, so it will be 8 d square divided by 4, so it will be 2 d square into pi, that is going to be the area under this area under compression. So that area into E, this E of the plate material divided by L, that is going to be the stiffness. So this is going to be the stiffness. So this is the stiffness of the plate. If there are two stiffness there, so you can find out the combined stiffness using this equation. This equation will be the effective of this total thing. Now, we want to plot the load deflection. When you tighten these two plates, this is plate 1 and this is plate 2, and they are held together or clamped together with the help of the bolt. When you tighten the knot of the bolt gets elongated, and it is exerting a force P on the bolt. The same amount of the force will also be exerted on the both the plates. So the clamping force will be P and the extension force will be also P. If we consider PI is the initial extension force because of the tightening, the same PI will be applied on the plate. So PI will be the extension force on the bolt, and PI will also be the initial clamping force on the plate. So if that is, if you apply PI amount of the force on the bolt, so it will be giving a deflection of delta B. So delta B will be equal to PI by KB. KB will be the stiffness of the board. So if you want to plot them together, so if you see delta B will be the deflection and PI will be the force. So it will, as you go on increasing the PI while tightening the dot, so you will also, the bolt will also get extended by an amount delta B. So this is the bolt's extension. And when you apply the same amount of PI force, because the bolt is clamping these two plates together, same PI amount will be applied to the plate, these two plates. So this, when the plate, the stiffness, effective stiffness of the plate is KC, the component KC, then the deflection will be, actually PI will be KC into delta C. So delta C, so this will be the slope, will be the KC. So you see the same PI amount and it will decrease in this. Now, when the part is subjected to an external force apart from this, now this is the initial tightening force. This side is the load, this side is deflection. The initial tightening force will be PI both on the bolt, that is in tensile nature, and on the component it is compressive in nature, but the stiffness is different, so that's why the slope will be different, these two curves. So this will be having different amount of deflection, this will be having different amount of elongation. This will be in curve. Now, when you increase the force by a magnitude P, and P, so if you increase the force in the system where these two plates are together, so that will affect the, that means total P will be shared by the component as well as the bolt together. If you increase the force on the system, so the member will share partially and the plate will be sharing partially. Let delta P is the amount of the total load P that the bolt is sharing. If the bolt is sharing delta P, so the bolt, this will move in this fashion and it will reach to this point where the bolt will be PB and the load PB will be PI plus delta P. And because of delta P, additional amount of deflection will happen. And the bolt is further elongated by an amount delta delta. So this side is delta delta. This side is delta delta. And so the bolt load is increased by an amount delta P, and the extension in the bolt is delta delta. At the same time, the compression of the two parts are relieved by the same amount of delta delta, because the bolt gets elongated by an amount of delta delta, the plates or the two parts or the components which are clamped by the bolt, as the bolt gets elongated, they are relieved by the same amount, which is delta delta. So the corresponding reduction in the load, clamping load, will be P minus delta P, delta P, because of this the load increase, increase in load on the bolt is delta P, thereby the reduction of the load on the parts will be P minus delta P. So that's why the stiffness KB of the bolt is actually delta P by delta delta, or you can say PI by delta B, P initial by delta B, that whichever is first. But this is our region of interest, so we will take this one. And similarly, the KC, the stiffness, is equal to P minus delta P, because this will be the P minus delta P divided by this delta is going to give you. So when you join these two things, so you can say delta P is equal to P into KB divided by KB plus CC. By solving these two, we can get this delta P is equal to P into KB divided by KB plus C. So this is the, now the bolt, total load shared by the bolt is actually PB is equal to P initial plus by an amount delta P. Delta P, we know it is coming out to be, delta P is coming out to be P, the additional load, into KB divided by KB plus KC. KB is the bolt stiffness, KC is the component stiffness. But furthermore, we can see from this triangle OMC and from the triangle OAG, we can see this divided by this is equal to this divided by this. So what is this? This much is equal to PB max. So PB max divided by, so this is PB max divided by, sorry, now we go to the other place. From the similar triangle OMC and OAG, we can see OMC MC by AG is equal to OC divided by OB. So in this case, MC by AG is equal to OC. OC is equal to delta B plus delta C and divided by delta B. So in this case, MC is equal to PB, that is PB max. So PB max is equal to PI, which is this one, AG, we have taken this side, this has gone to this side, so PI into delta V plus delta C, so this is Bohm equation. Other equation we already know, delta P is equal to P into KB by this. So PB is equal to PI plus delta P, and that is equal to PI plus P into KB divided by KB plus KC. So this is the equation. Sometimes we say KB by KC is equal to, or KC by KB is equal to A is equal to KC by KB, and that is the stiffness ratio of the connected parts, connected parts to the stiffness of the bolt. Stiffness ratio of the connected parts to the bolt stiffness. If that is the case, so we can find out delta P is equal to P into 1 divided by 1 plus A, we can do, and this is equal to PB will be equal to PI plus delta P. Now we can consider on this basis for soft gasket, what you do, A is equal to 0. Because the KC by KB is equal to 0, because KC is component, so KC by KB is equal to tends to 0, so delta P will be equal to 1 divided by 1 plus 0 into P, so that is equal to P, so PB is equal to PI plus P, so this will be the, for soft gasket, it will be, PB will be this. For hard gasket, the gasket is the member which is placed in between the component. Suppose this is the part and this is the gasket. So if both are connected by bolt, so how, if this is the KC, if it is KC is larger than KB, so KC by KB will be, this is KC by KB will be very large number, and so 1 divided by 1 plus A into P is equal to delta P in this case, so delta P is equal to 1 divided by 1 plus infinite into P, that is 1 by infinite into P is equal to 0. So PB is equal to initial plus delta P, in this case it will be 0, is equal to Pi. So for hard gasket, it will be delta P will be 0 and the PV will be this one. For soft gasket, it is actually PV load on the bolt is equal to Pi plus P. Here we will go explain the effect of bolt's extension on the clamping of two plates. Here we will explain this thing with the help of an example. Let's say this is plate 1 and plate 2. Both are joined with the help of a bolt as shown in the figure. The diameter of the bolt is D. The plates, the external diameter is equal to 2D. And both the plates have a hole through which the bolt is inserted and then they are clamped. When you are tightening the bolt is getting elongated and the both the plates 1 and plate 2, both the plates get compressed. And the thickness of both the plates are 25 millimeter and 25 millimeter. So the bolt length will be also equal to 25 millimeter. Here we are going to find out the diameter of the bolt to withstand a particular load which is equal to 10 kilonewton. Well, we have to find out the diameter of the bolt. What should be the diameter of the bolt so that with an pre load or initial load of 5 kilonewton because of the tightening and additional load of 10 kilonewton because of the external load can be managed or can be handled by the bolt which are going to join or clamp these two plates. The plates material is given, the bolt material is also given. Bolt has the yield strength of 380 megapascal and whereas the Young's modulus is 207 gigapascal. The plate material is given which is made up of aluminium and the elastic modulus or Young's modulus is 71,000 megapascal or 71 gigapascal it is given. So if that is there, we actually want to find out what is the maximum PV which is equal to initial load plus the delta P. So to find out delta P, we have to know the external load into KB divided by KB plus KC. So these are the stiffness of the bolt and this is the stiffness of the component. So to find out the stiffness of the bolt, we have to find out area of the bolt, the elastic modulus of the bolt and the length of the bolt. And in this case, it is also the area of the component in the elastic modulus of the component and length. Length is 25 plus 25, 50. It is given in both the case. This is known, this is known. Area is known, this is known. So we have to find out this, what is the magnitude of delta V. And once we know that one, the factor of safety is given. The allowable strength of the material is given. So this divided by allowable strength is equal to this load, which is the total load, which is the initial load plus this divided by the area of the bolt. So we want to find out the diameter of the bolt from this. So from that, let's say what is the maximum allowable strength that the bolt can sustain. The bolt's materials yield strength is 380 megapascal, it is given. When you divide that by the factor of safety, that will be the limit of the stress that the bolt should be within that. Otherwise, more than that, the bolt is considered to be failing. So, in this case, 380 divided by 2.5 is equal to 152 megapascal. That is the allowable strength of the bolt material. Now, the bolt is subjected to initial load of P. Magnitude is 5 kilonewton and an external load of 10 kilonewton. So because of the external load, partly it will be shared by the plates together, the plates to be clamped, and partly it is shared by the bolt together. So this share of the bolt is given by delta P, and that delta P is equal to the external load into KB divided by KB plus KC. So to find out KB, we have to know what is KB. KB is equal to area of the bolt into this KB is equal to area of the bolt into elastic modulus of the bolt divided by L. So pi by 4 d square into E by L in this case pi by 4, d square we don't know because we have to find out the diameter of the bolt. E is given 207 into 20 by 3 Newton per millimeter square divided by L is given 50. L is equal to length of the bolt, which is equal to 25 plus 25, it is 50. So we find out KB, and KB is coming out to be, in this case it is coming out to some value, that is 3251.5 d square. So that is the KB value. KC in this case, area of the component into this component is actually a hollow component with outside diameter is d 2d, the inside diameter is d. So in this case the area will be pi by 4 2 d square minus pi by 4 d square. So in this case we find out it is coming out to be 2.356 d square. So the stiffness of the component is actually area of the component is 2.5 d square into the aluminum material elastic modulus, that is 71,000 Newton per millimeter square. The length is 50. So in this case we find out this is to be this much, 2.35 d square. So in this the KB by KC we can find out KB by this we can find out delta P is equal to P into KB divided by KB plus KC. So in this case delta P is known, it is 10 kilonewton. P is 10 kilonewton. This KB is already known. This is known. This is known. So you can find out the magnitude of delta P. Once you find out the magnitude of delta P, so initial load is PI. So PB is equal to the initial load. The load on the bolt is equal to PB. PB is equal to load on the bolt, that is equal to initial load plus delta P. So PI is equal to 5000 Newton, and delta P we have found out. It is to be 5000 Newton. So in this case delta P is equal to the initial load PI. So this is equal to P into KB divided by KB plus KC. So in this case KB is this one, KB plus KC is equal to this one. So when we find out, solve this, we will get this, and this is equal to 492, and PB is equal to this. Now the stress is limited, the stress allowable is equal to 152 Newton per millimeter square that bolt material can withstand, that we get by dividing the factor of safety in the sigma yt. So this PB divided by A is equal to 152. So PB is equal to 9928 divided by A is equal to 152. So in this case, so area of the bolt is equal to 9928 Newton divided by 152 Newton per millimeter square. That is going to give you the total, that is about 65.3 millimeter square. So that is the one we look for the table. And when we look for the table, the M12 bolt has an area of 84.3 millimeter square. M10 is less than this, so we'll take this one. So this is the area of the bolt. So in this case what we have understood, that when we do the elastic analysis of the bolt, that means when the bolt is getting stressed, we have to consider the initial load of the bolt plus the external load. So we'll discuss the bolt under uniform fluctuating load. We have already seen that bolt under elastic limit, where we have seen that because of the initial tightening load, the total load on the bolt will be equal to the initial load plus a part of the external load. That. But here in this case, when the bolt is subjected to fluctuating load, we have seen that the endurance limit is the limit for the design of a fluctuating load. In this case, How do you find out the endurance limit? Endurance limit is equal to, actually, SI is equal to K into KB. That is K into KB into KC into KD into SC dash. SC dash we normally get it from the empirical relation, and this is the reliability. This is the reliability factor. This is the surface finish factor. Surface finish factor. This is the size factor. And this is the reliability factor, and this is the stress concentration factor. In this case, we have to consider all the factors, and once we find out the endurance limit, we know this one. So we draw a line which is known as Gottman's line, which is falling within this region, it is safe. Is going beyond this, it is failure. So what do we do on for fluctuating load? We have seen that it has some mean component and some stress amplitude, or in that case we draw the relation, draw the equation of that which is having some sigma a and some sigma m, and the point of intersection of this point with the Gottman's line, Gottman's line is actually AC divided by, sorry, sigma is equal to sigma a by AC plus sigma m by sigma ut is equal to 1. So in this, that is the line of the Gottman's line equation. This line equation, the meeting point, is going to decide the limit of maximum value of stress amplitude you can apply, and the limit of sigma m you can apply, so that it will have an infinite life. Beyond that, it will have other life with less than infinite life. So in this case, the following some important points has to be remembered before doing this. In while it is finding out the endurance limit for the bolt, it is not necessary to consider the surface finish factor separately. It is actually incorporated in the fatigue stress concentration factor. So for bolt, you don't have to consider this one, right? And the size factor is always taken as 1. In this case, it is not considered. K is not considered separately. This is taken as 1. Reliability factor we consider. And the stress concentration factor also we have to consider. Reliability factor is always considered to be 90%. So 90% we have to consider. According to SI, the metric specification, SI and metric specification, bolt grades are numbered as per their tensile strength. Higher the tensile strength, more is the grade number. Normally, bolts are made by cutting the threads on them. However, some rolled threads are also produced. But the rolled threads have smoother thread finish than the cut threads. Rolling also provides an unbreakable flow of material grain in the threaded region, whereas when you are creating a thread by cutting it, it is actually cutting the grains in the threaded region. Therefore, rolled threads are preferred for applications subjected to fluctuating loads. So for rolled threads, the reliability factor is 9%, and we don't consider the stress concentration separately, because it is already there. And if you consider the total failure, about 15% of the bolt failure takes place at the head region. If you consider this as the bolt, and this is the threaded region, and this is the shank region, this is the fillet, so 15% of the bolt failure takes place at this location. And 20% of the bolt failure occurs at the end of the shank where the thread starts. So 20% of the failure takes place at this region where the thread, but rest 65% of the failure takes place at the location where the knot is there. At knot is there, so 65% of the failure takes place at this region. So when we do the, we know the bolt is subjected to the initial load plus delta P in this case. So delta P, PI plus delta P is P, the P external, into KB divided by KB plus KC, right? So PV. So normally the if you see the time versus the it is changing, it is actually changing from like this. Let's say it is this is the PB and this is the PI, and it is varying in between them. And when it is varying in between them, we can this is so we can see the PB max is equal to PI plus delta P, that is equal to PI. This is because of the initial tightening, and this is P into KB divided by KB plus KC. These KB and KC are the stiffness of the bolt and stiffness of the bolt, and this is stiffness of the component. P minimum is equal to PI, so it is varying from that. So the average, P average or P min is equal to 1 by 2 PI plus delta P. Delta P, PI plus delta P plus PI, if that is equal to 2PI plus delta P by 2, that is PI plus delta P by 2. But so P average is equal to PI plus delta P, we can say it is P into KB divided by KB plus KC. This is, we said this entire thing is C, so that is equal to PI plus P CP by 2. So this is P average or P mean. P mean or P average. P mean. Or P stress amplitude, that is equal to PI plus delta P minus PI by 2, that is equal to delta P by 2, that is equal to PC by 2. So actually P mean is equal to PI plus PA. In this case we can find out this. So if I divided by area of the bolt everywhere, we can see that this is equal to sigma mean is equal to the initial load PI by A plus this is this is average. So this is equal to sigma average. So this is the equation. This now if I draw another equation where I am going to plot this one. This is the y-axis, this is the x-axis, this side is sigma mean, this side is sigma average, and if this point is the endurance limit, this is and this side is the sigma ultimate limit. So if I join them together, this is the Godman's line. And now the equation we got from here, sigma mean is equal to PI by A plus sigma A. So if this is the x-axis, this is the y-axis, we get equation x is equal to y plus something. So it is a straight line. So at sigma mean is equal to 0. Mean is equal to 0. That means at x is equal to 0. So it will be pi by a minus is equal to sigma. Say, so this will be this. So sigma a will be equal to minus pi by a. So if I consider this one, so this side is positive and this side is negative, and this is pi by a. So this side is, this is the point when this is the point away from x axis, and when we consider at sigma a is equal to 0, when we consider a is equal to 0, so from this equation, this is 0, sigma mean is equal to pi by a, so sigma mean will be here, so this is also pi by a, so this line is cutting equally on to x and y axis, so this angle will be 45 degree, this angle will be 45 degree, and the point where it meets the Gordman's line is going to decide the limit of the stress amplitude and the limit of the sigma mean, that when applied to the bolt will have infinite life. So using Gordman's line, we have to find the equation of, equation is this one, the equation is, equation of this line is equal to sigma a divided by sc plus sigma mean divided by sigma ut, that is equal to 1. So using this equation and using this equation, you can find out right. So solving these two equations, we can find out these two points, and that is going to, if we do solve that, then we will find out in this manner. So when we saw the first equation is, the first Gordman's equation, Gordman's equation is equal to sigma a divided by fc plus sigma m divided by sigma ut is equal to 1. Or we can say sigma a by sc is equal to 1 minus sigma m by sigma ut. Or we can say sigma a is equal to sc whole into 1 minus sigma m divided by sigma ut. So this is, we kept it. The other equation we get it from here, sigma m is equal to pi by a plus sigma a. So in this case we can say sigma a or you can say in this sigma a is equal to sigma m minus pi by a. So this is the option. So or when we compare them, or we can say sigma m is equal to pi by a plus sigma a. This is one, the equation. Other case we can also find out sigma m. So sigma m is equal to sigma ut into 1 minus sigma a by sc. So we can compare this two together. That is equal to pi by a plus sigma a from this one and from this one. We can call right side of this one and right side of this one. Can keep it. That is sigma ut into 1 minus sigma a by sc. And we can find out comparing what is sigma. We can take sigma a. And so sigma a this side is equal to plus sigma ut into sigma a by sc is equal to sigma ut minus pi by a. So in this case we can find out sigma a is equal to sigma ut minus pi by a whole divided by 1 plus sigma ut by sc. So in this case we can find out this one. So once you find out sigma A, so sigma A is equal to sigma UT minus PI by A divided by 1 plus sigma UT divided by FC. So this is known, this is known, this is known, this one, once you know this everything, you can find out what is sigma A. And once you find out sigma A, that is equal, that has to be compared to the sigma allowable divided by the factor of safety. We can find out from there. So this is the stress amplitude that has to be compared. This stress has amplitude has to be compared and has to be within the allowable limit. So this, we can solve this, solve a problem on this, we can understand what is going to happen. In this problem, we are going to find out the diameter of the bolt which is going to connect these two plates together under the fluctuating load. And in this case, the normal finding out the fluctuating load with initial tension and with a static load with initial tension and fluctuating load on initial tension, both are different. So in this case, we'll explain what should be the diameter and how do you find out the diameter of the bolt when the plates are subjected to fluctuating load. So this is basically two circular plates. They are clamped together by means of the bolt, and the load on the bolt varies from 0 to 10 kilonewton. 0 to 10 kilonewton, the load is varying, and the magnitude of P is varying from, this is the external load, and the material of the bolt is given to be, ultimate strength of the bolt is given to be 630 megapascal, and the bolt materials, Young's modulus is given 207 gigapascal. And plate 1 and plate 2, these plate 1 and plate 2 are made up of aluminium, and where the elastic modulus is given 71,000 megapascal. The initial load on the tightening load because of the knot is 5 kilonewton, and the stress concentration factor is given to be 2.2, and the reliability factor is 9%. We will not consider separately the surface finish factor because it is already considered in this KD. And the other factor will also, like size factor, will consider to be 1, and the factor of safety is given to be 2, and we want to find out the diameter of the bolt. In this case, the diameter of the bolt. So this is the clear case where the bolt is subjected to an fluctuating load. So in this case, we have to find out what is the endurance limit. When it is subjected to fluctuating load, it is, and which is varying from 0 to 10 kilonewton, what is the endurance limit? And what is the, we have to find a look at the location by location of the point on the location on the Godman's line. So we have to find out Godman's line. So to know the Godman's line, we have to find out two loads. This side is stress amplitude, this side is mean. So we have, and if we find out this point, so this point will be the stress limit, fluctuating stress limit on the stress amplitude, and the side will be mean, which is better. We will consider that as the, normally the stress amplitude is considered as the limit for design, so we will consider. So the fact is, we have to find out this location. How do you find out this location? If you know the equation of this line and equation of this line, then the point of intersection of this will be the line. So to know that, what you have to find out? AC. So AC, the equation of this line is equal to sigma A divided by AC plus sigma M divided by sigma UT is equal to 1. So sigma UT is given, AC we do not know. So these are two unknowns. This is y axis, this is x axis. And here we will find out another equation of this line. And so two unknowns and two lines, we will find out this. So to find out AC, we know that AC is equal to KA, KB, KC, KD into AC dash. So AC dash is actually 50% of the ultimate strength. That is an empirical relation we find out. So we know this AC dash, this is known. KD is the stress concentration factor. KC is the reliability factor. KB is the psi factor. We consider Chi factor 1. We don't consider KA separately. So in this KC for 90% of reliability is this. We find out from the table. KD is equal to actually 1 divided by actual stress concentration factor, which is given to be 2.2. In this case, we found. So we find out this case. So we know what is AC. In this, AC is equal to 1 into this into this into this is equal to this. This is, we know the AC. We know this point, we know this point. So we know the equation of this line, S sigma, already known. The other equation of the line we want to find out. So to know that, we know that the load is varying from, we know that the load is varying from 0 to 10 kN. So in that case, what is the KB? We have to find KB. What do we want to find? KC, which is the bolt stiffness. This is the bolt stiffness. And what we have to find? KC, it is to find out the plate stiffness. The plate is actually like this, which is having a diameter. In this case, it is 2D and this is D. So in this case, area of the bolt is known. So KB is actually pi by 4 D square into bolt is 207 into 10 to the power 3 E by L. L is equal to 50 in this case, because two plates are there. One plate length is 25, other plate length is 25, it is given. So this L is equal to 50. In this case, we can find out KB is equal to 3251.5 D square. Similarly, KC we can find out using this. KC is equal to pi by 4. This is 2D square minus D square, that is the area, into, in this case, aluminum plate is aluminum, 10 to the 3 divided by 50, it is coming out to be 3345 D square. So now we can find out what is C. C is actually KB divided by KB plus KC. That is, we can find out what is the value of C. This C is coming out to be 0.492. Right. So load PV, which is actually P max is equal to P initial plus the P into Cp. So P in this case, C into P. P in this case is equal to 10,000 Newton. C is known. So it is 5,000 is the initial load, plus C is 0.4929. into P is 10,000. So in this case, it is coming out to be 9,929. P minimum is equal to, that is equal to, P minimum is equal to PI, that is equal to 5,000. So in this case, so we know P average or P mean is equal to this plus this by 2. In this case, it is coming out to be 9,929 plus 5,000 divided by 2. It is coming out to be 7,464. And P average is equal to coming out to 9,929 minus 5,000 by 2. It is coming out to 2,464.9. So this is the we got. Now, the when we divide this thing by area, we are going to give the stress amplitude as well as the mean stress. So, the first equation is SA, or we can say sigma A, divided by the endurance limit. Endurance limit we can already find out. that is 128.42 plus, we know the Godman's line. So this is SM, or you can be sigma, sigma A divided by 128.42 plus sigma M divided by ultimate strength, which is coming out to 630, is equal to 1. This is equation 1. The other equation we have found out is SM is equal to PI by A plus SA. In this case, PI is equal to 5000 divided by A plus A is the area of the board, SA. So when we, this is equation 1, when this is equation 2, and we keep compare SM from, in this case sigma, not sigma, it is not, let's say this is sigma. When we compare this, we can find out the sigma A in this case is equal to sigma UT minus PI by A divided by 1 plus sigma UT divided by the endurance limit. So endurance limit is known, this is known, this side is known, this is known, only thing is this is known, and this is actually the factor of safety, the allowable stress limit divided by factor of safety. The allowable stress is given, that is 380, so this is 380 divided by factor of safety. The factor of safety is 2, that is equal to, in this case it is 630 minus PI is 5000 divided by A divided by 1 plus 630 divided by SC, we got 128.4. So in this case we will find out what is the size of A. A is coming out to be, in this case A is coming out to be 54. We solve this for the, solve this one for, because the only unknown is A, we found it is called 54.1 millimeter square. Look for the table where the area is this, and in this case M10 into 1.25 has an area of 61.2 millimeters. So this is going very close to this, and this is the fine threaded bolt M10 into 1.25 is suitable for this application. This value we get it from the table. So few more problems. Before that we have understood the because of the elastic analysis, the tightening load, initial tightening load I, PI, and this is the external load. So the load on the bolt is equal to initial tightening load PI plus C into P, where C is equal to KB divided by KB plus KC, where KB is the stiffness of the bolt, this is the stiffness of the component. And if this is the load shared by the bolt, so the load shared by the member or the component will be 1 minus C into the external load T minus P by PI. So to make the joint leak proof, the load shared by the member should be always less than equal to 0, otherwise leak. So in this case, if this is equal to 1 minus C into P minus FI is equal to 0, so 1 minus C into external load is equal to F. This is PI, not PI. This is PI. This is PI. So this is the equation that will make the joint leak proof. Now we, with this knowledge, we'll solve a problem of a M24 bolt, metric 24 foot bolt. And what is the tensile stress in the bolt to make the joint leak proof? So to make the joint leak proof, we have to know the initial tightening should be such that it is not doing any leak, and the what is the magnitude of stress in that case. So you know, the to make the joint leak proof, the initial tightening is given by an empirical relation, that is equal to 28 140 into d is the diameter of the bolt. So dc is, you know, the core diameter of the bolt is equal to 0.84 times the diameter of the bolt. So this is the dia of the bolt, nominal dia or major dia, and this is the core dia of the bolt. This is the core dia of the bolt. So if pi is known, so the sigma t, and there is no external load on that, so in this case pv is equal to pi plus another zero. So pi is equal to total load on this bolt is equal to pi, that is equal to 240d divided by pi by 4 into this square. So this will give you the magnitude of the stress that is developed in the bolt when it is 213.5 megapascal, then it will make the joint leak proof. So the next question is, for a M36 into 4, so this is the major diameter of the bolt and this is the pitch of the bolt, with a material whose yield strength is 200 mega or 80 megapascal and the factor of safety is 1.5, find the strength of the bolt. So we know the strength of the bolt, P is equal to pi by 4 into dc square into sigma allowable. In this case, sigma allowable is equal to 280 newton per millimeter square divided by factor of safety 1.5, and that is coming out to whatever. And then we know dc is equal to 0.84 into 34, because the d is the given, so putting everything, p is equal to pi by 4. DC 0.84 into 34 square into sigma allowable is 280 divided by 1.5, it is coming out to 134. So the bolt diameter is 36, so on solving you will get what is the load taken by the bolt. Now if the question 3, that what is the load lifted, on a bolt of pitch is equal to 4 millimeter with a tightening torque of 1.4 kilonewton millimeter when it is turned by one rotation. So when a bolt is rotated by one rotation, so it will be moving an angle of 2 pi, and when it is rotated by an angle 2 pi, this will be the pitch amount and this will be the 2 pi r, right? So this will be the inclination of the wedge angle of the thread. So in this case, the work done, it is just like a lifting a material on the inclined plane, and the distance it traveled is equal to this much, which is equal to force into displacement, that is equal to, in this case it is pitch, and is equal to torque into angular displacement. Angular displacement in this case is 2 pi for one rotation, and torque is given 1.4 into 10 to the power 3 newton millimeter into 2 pi, and this force which is being lifted, that is equal to into the displacement, is in this case is the 1 pitch. When it is rotated by once, so it will be giving 4 millimeter, because the pitch is equal to 4 millimeter. So the force or the weight lifted, 1.4 into 10 to the 3 into 2 pi divided by 4, it is coming out to 2.2 kilonewton. So weight lifted is equal to this much, equal to 2.2 kilonewton. So this is another problem. In this case, it is given that if the external load on the bolted joint is 9.6 kilonewton, after tightening the bolt with an initial tightening load of 5.3 kilonewton, after tightening the bolt with an initial tightening load of 5.3 kilonewton, and it is here given KB divided by KB plus KC, which is C, is given to be 0.25. Find the share of the load taken by the bolt. So what is the share of the load taken by the bolt? What is the share of the PM is equal to, we know, 1 minus C into P A minus PI with the system. So this is the load taken by component, and PV is the load taken by the bolt. This is the initial load, and C is given, and initial load is given to be 5.3 into 10 to the power 3 newton, that is equal to PI, C is 0.25, and P is given to be 9.6 into 10 to the power 3 newton. So everything is given. So in this case, PV is equal to 0.25 into 9.6 plus 5.3, that is equal to 7.7 kilonewton. In this case, we are coming across another problem. The problem says, what is the ratio of the external load, that is P, to the initial tightening load, that is equal to PI. So the ratio of P by PI is how much when the joint is applied to when the joint is a leak proof joint and having bolt stiffness which is equal to one fourth of the component stiffness. That means the stiffness of the bolt is equal to 1 by 4 of the stiffness of the component. So KC is actually 4 into KB. It is given. So to make the joint, we know the PM is equal to 1 minus C into the external load minus PI. P is the initial tightening load, P is the external load, this is the initial load on the bolt. So when this becomes 0, PM is less than equal to 0, the joint is leak proof. For leak proof. So that we make it 0, so 1 minus C into P is equal to PI. So 1 minus C, we want to find out P by PI. So in this case, this implies P divided by PI is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus C. So what is C? C is actually, in this case, C is equal to KB divided by KB plus KC. So in this case, we know KB divided by KB plus KC is equal to 4KB. This is equal to KB divided by C is equal to KB by 5KB. So C is equal to 0.2. So P by PI is equal to 1 divided by 1 minus 0.2. That is equal to 1 divided by 0.8 is equal to 1.25. So the external load, when it is 1.25 times the initial load, the joint is the leak proof. For a
stiffness ratio. There is a joint, and in this joint there are 12 bolts, and that is a joint of a pressure vessel or a flange that containing 12 bolts. So in this case 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12 bolts. So n is equal to 12 bolts. We don't know the diameter of the bolt. Diameter of the bolt we do not know, and it is actually attached to a cylindrical vessel, and that pressure prevailing in that is equal to pressure in that is equal to 2 megapascal, and the large diameter in this case, the diameter of this in this case is given, diameter D is equal to 250 millimeter, and the stiffness of the bolt as well as the components, the ratio KB by KB plus KC is given. So in this case, to make the joint leak proof, what should be the diameter of the bolt? So in this case, as the number of bolts is given and we have to make the joint leak proof, we know the two load on the member is equal to 1 minus C into the external load minus FPI, and to make this joint, this has to be less than or equal to 0. So PM is equal to less than or equal to 0. So 1 minus C into P minus PI should be less than or equal to 0. So in this case, or you can say at the base it will be equal to 0. 1 minus C into P is equal to PI. So in this case, PI is equal to 1 minus 0.1 C is given. P is equal to, what is the P? The external pressure pi by 4 into 250 square is the area into 2 divided by number of bolt is 12. So per bolt is this much. So we can find out what is the value of this. So in this case, this P is equal to total pressure, which is equal to pi by 4 and 250 square into 2 megapascal into 2 into 10 newton per millimeter square divided by number of bolts is 12. Number of bolts, and this is the area of the drum, and this is the pressure. So we find out this, what is the value of P? P is known.